This is going to be the first of a series of videos about the properties of exponents. So let's start with what happens when you multiply two numbers with exponents. Let's say we've got a number x, and it's got an exponent of 2. It's x squared. And we want to multiply it by x to the third. Well, let's see what we're really doing. X would be the same as x times x. And we're multiplying that by x to the third, which is the same as x times x times x. Now, if we look at what we have here, we've got five x's that are all being multiplied. So this would come out to x to the fifth. A simple way of doing it without writing all those x's would just be to add the 2, the exponent for the first x, which is what we have here, and the 3, the exponent for the second x, which is what we have here, and we would get x to the 2 plus 3, and then of course 2 plus 3 is 5. So we have x to the fifth. In general, this rule was usually written like this: x to the m, and m could be any number at all, times x to the n, and n could be any number at all, is going to equal x to the m plus n. So the bottom line for multiplying two numbers with exponents, the numbers have to be the same, the bases, in other words, have to be the same. The bottom line is keep the base the same and just add the two exponents together. Okay? Now, so that's multiplication. Let's look at division. Let's say that we want to divide, I don't know, let's take x to the fifth, and we want to divide that by x to the third. Okay, so what are we really doing? X to the fifth is x times x times x times x times x. And x to the third is x times x times x. Now, if we look at this, we could cancel out this x and this x, this one and this one, this one and this one. We'd end up with a 1 in the denominator. And all we have in the numerator is x times x, which is x squared. So in other words, we subtracted, you could say, 3 x's out of the denominator, and at the same time subtracted, or eliminated, I guess would be a better word, eliminated 3 x's from the numerator. So we took the number of x's in the denominator, took them away from both the denominator and the numerator, which would be a way of saying that we took this exponent in the numerator, the x to the fifth, and we subtracted the exponent in the denominator, the 3. When we do the subtraction, we get x squared. So the general rule that explains this is going to be written as x to the m, and m could be any number, divided by x to the n is going to be the same as x to the m minus n. Okay? So you've got two numbers, they've got the same base, and each one has an exponent. You're dividing one by the other. You take the exponent in the denominator, subtract it from the exponent in the numerator, and that will give you a solution. Now, this is a good time to explain the value of x to the 0. So let's think about how we might get something like an x to the 0. Let's say we wanted to use this rule for division, and we had x to the third divided by x to the third. Well, the rule will tell us that we subtract 3 from 3. So we're going to have x from the to the third minus 3. 3 minus 3 is 0, so that equals 0, x to the 0. But we also know that any number divided by itself equals 1. So we now have another rule. When we raise a base to a 0 power, what we're going to get is 1. This is assuming that the base is not a 0. Okay, so if you have any number other than 0 where the x is, and you raise it to the 0 power, what you end up with is just a 1. Okay, let's see if we can fit in one more, and then we'll do some more in the next video. So the next example tells us what you do if you have a base that's raised, let's say, to some power, so x squared, and then we want to take that whole thing and raise it to another power. Okay, so we have some number with an exponent raised to yet a higher power. Well, let's see what this means. We've got x squared, and we're cubing it. So we've got x squared times x squared times x squared. Well, one way to think of this would be if we're multiplying these three, we would just add this and this and this. We would get three of these twos. In other words, we've got x times x to the 2 plus 2 plus 2. That's our multiplication rule. And 2 plus 2 plus 2 is the same as 3 twos, which is what we've got over here. We've got 3 of these twos. This is going to be x to the 6th. And doing that without writing all this out, we could just see that by multiplying 2 times 3, we would get x to the 6th. So our general rule for raising a number to a higher power is going to be to take the exponent of the number and then the power we're raising it to, multiply those two together, and that will be our answer. So x to the m raised to the nth power is going to be x to the m times n. Okay, that's all the time we have for in this video. I'm going to continue this in the second one.